Greetings, fellow friends of Louis, Rhadamant here. Thank you for tuning in to Project Zomboid, King of Louisville, Episode 35, Louis the Lumberman. According to the wiki, traps will not catch anything while players within 75 tiles of them. Yeah, I already know that. I thought it was 50, so thank you for doing the research, but yeah, I already knew that. It doesn't work the way I laid it out. Not unless I'm not home. Expanding flooring on second level has won. Okay. All right. Sounds good to me. Let's put this corpse away. So for that, I'm going to need a lot more wood, and I'm going to get the wood, I'm going to go on a little bit of an excursion for it, rather than break down furniture for like a year, because I'll be out that forever. So there's a few things I need for that, I think. Also, let's check on the lake. I am, at this point, actually surprised I'm not healed from the fracture. Truly. It has been so long. How long does it last? Let's see. It doesn't say. The wiki's just like, you'll heal eventually. Thanks, wiki. Useful as always. An infinite inspiration. Well, the good news is I'm mostly mobile. I'm moving around just fine. So yeah, there's barely a limp. Let's go do it. Where did I put all the rope I had? Didn't I have like an enormous amount of rope? And that's what I broke my leg getting? Oh, is it in my trunk? It might be in my trunk. I didn't get the strawberries upstairs, so I'll do that first. And then, I'll expand flooring. And now all the strawberries, and I think the carrots are ready as well. Seed bearing. Oh, no, no. Those aren't carrots. Those are potatoes. Seedling, seedling, seedling. Okay. That was it. I'm such a glutton. Every time I get strawberries, I just like immediately start eating them. I mean, they're fresh, right? I'll freeze these. Freeze this batch. Thank you for the reminder, Dangerfield. Alright, ambulance's trunk is empty. Where did I put my ropes? They're in the SUV's trunk. That makes sense. All right. I am gonna quickly repair. Oh, I might not have the skills for it. Let me double check. That trunk looks sad. Trunk lid. Yeah, I can repair it. Let's grab a metal sheet and just fix it up a little. Looks kind of beat up. Look at that repair. I'll repair the hood then too. Windshield, heater, those are the ones that are real beat up. What happened to my leg? I fell off a catwalk. Off of my roof. And when I landed, I had a shin fracture. They need to add a way to make ice cream. Yeah, I agree. So, I'm driving somewhere that I think is going to have a lot of wood. Even though I'm injured and can't fight as well. So it's a bit of a risk. Worst case scenario, I can always jump in the vehicle and just run away. Drive away. I was hoping to come into this factory here. But I'm going to drive around it, I think. Try not to attract too much attention. So this is how far I would need to travel to fish, if you're wondering. It really isn't that far. There is not exactly a safe spot to do the fishing. That would be the only concern. Because fishing is typically something that takes a while, and... And you often want to accelerate time. Well, the other thing is with a shin splint, I should probably not stomp. So I'll have to remind myself not to stomp these zombies to death. Yeah, you can see how it's less than ideal. Limping away from me. We're good. Have I tried crafting spears? Yeah. I mean, I've used every weapon. I'm not new to Zomboid. I have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours. I'm using long blunt because of the traits I have. Given that I have an XP boost to long blunt. Can you spearfish? Not that I know of. Not yet, at least. Oh, you can spearfish? Cool. I don't spend any time doing fishing in the game, so I know nothing about fishing. Other than, like, the simple casting nets. Oh, I just attracted more than I wanted. Don't get panicked, dude. Why do the other ones not follow me? That's super weird. Because I drove up, pissed them off, and they just, like, forgot about me. Really? That zombie took 4 swings? Louis, you're out of practice. to be a... Oh, you know, there's a lot of zombies in there. And these are bricks, aren't they? Well, I can cut down the trees if I secure the area. So, there's always that backup plan. I'll cut my own lumber. I'm very hot. Oh, there's a few zombies behind me, too. That works. There's not a lot of big trees here, but like, beggars can't be choosers. I'll cut a few trees down. And then have all the rope to tie the logs into bundles, because they're easier to transport that way. But if I'm going to be cutting trees down and getting exerted, you better believe I don't want zombies around me. So I'm clearing them out so that I can work in peace, relative peace. Zombies ahead. I guess I'll clear them up first. What I don't want to do is piss off the zombies that are behind the fence on the other side and have them try to path to me. But that probably will end up happening anyway. And like five more from the northwest. Good crits though. So I wonder if these guys down here even know how to get to me. Oops, I just clicked. Hang on. I just minimized Zomboid for a second. That's not good. I wish I had a sledgehammer just to free them so that I could force them to come to me. That way I don't have to worry about them ambushing me later on. There's no destructible way out of there unless they go through the factory. Yeah. I just don't want them going through the factory, but it doesn't look like they're pathing to me anyway. They don't seem to be able to do it. It's rotted. I mean, it should be, right? I was just being hopeful. Okay. Let's get to work. I have a hand axe. Yeah, that was a bad choice. I should have grabbed a real axe. Oh well. Hi guys. I'm just Christmas tree shopping here, don't mind me. So the reason for the ropes is you can stack the logs together in a four log stack so that they take up less room if you have ropes or sheet ropes. Which is just a lot easier to transport high volume of wood. And then once I get back to the base, I'll saw the logs into planks. And that's definitely the efficient way of moving a lot of stuff. I'm glad that I didn't have to fight too many zombies up there. Because this wouldn't be more efficient than just, like, breaking down furniture if there was a lot of zombies for me to handle. I might make an exception. Because I know, Insufferable, you asked about the spears. Just to be able to poke those zombies on the other side of the fence. Because I don't necessarily want to have them growling at me forever. I don't know. Maybe they're my fan club. Never go dissing your fan club. Just making sure I'm alone. Well, alone outside of the zombies that I'm next to. Alright, I am getting drowsy and exerted, so maybe one more stack and I'll call it quits for the day. But it's a pretty good amount of wood that I already have. I'll really be able to expand the floor space, I think. Whoa! Don't hit the tree. I am definitely to the point where I ought to turn back, because if you get too tired, what ends up happening is if we have an incident back home, I'll not be able to manage it, because I'll be too exerted and tired to fight. One thing that would be nice, not that it's realistic for 1993, is if you had high enough electrical and mechanical skill, you could make an automatic door opener. Not saying it'd be realistic, and I'm sure there's mods for it, but yeah, I think that would be nice. All right, log stack. I'm going to do my sawing on the second floor, because I don't want to get nibbled. unstacked all logs. 20 logs. I'll put the ropes back, because I suspect I'm going to need more timber. I probably went overboard with the amount of ropes that I have. Okay. Well, 60 planks. Nice. It's pretty good, right? Definitely more efficient than going door to door breaking down furniture, I think. What bothers me a little bit is I'm putting in, oh, that looks super weird. Oh, because it's outdoor. Yeah, it doesn't know if it's outdoors or indoors. Because I would need to save and load. Or, yeah. So I am end up saving and loading just to fix this silliness. I think that's all I want on this section, so I'll start a flooring section over there. I mean, I wouldn't mind sitting on extra wood, because that allows me to build, like, doors and other nice-to-haves that I haven't had for a while. And also cover up those windows that are long overdue to be covered. What I will do, how about this, is while I work on this and suggest goals. Suggest some new goals for me. Who's putting in a lot of backbreaking work into this base, huh? One other thing that I could do, if I can secure the building to the southwest, just spitballing here, is create a, not a roof bridge, but a bridge at the current height that I'm at. Like a second story bridge over to the other building, as provided I've secured the other building. That could be interesting. But I'm almost at the two windows to the southwest that would need to be covered. Almost. And now that I've shown you how easy it is to get bulk plank, you know, if you wanted me to do more construction projects to the base, I could definitely grab a wood axe instead of a hatchet. How much did I bang up my hatchet? It's about half HP, a little more. But grab a wood axe and hack at trees the fast way. Or, alternatively, grab logs for log walls and secure the neighborhood. That was a goal proposed a long time ago that has been forgotten about. But I could see doing it again. Ah, this is the corner. Hard to tell, considering how dark it is. Oh, I guess there was three windows that I hadn't covered. Because here's another one. Right over the garage. And I'm planning on going all the way around so that there's a full perimeter. Burning the midnight oil just a wee bit. And for this, I will also... Oh, I am encumbered, though. I'll need a sledgehammer to break that railing. So I can circumnavigate. Circumnavigate my second floor. Please don't fall again. Well, at least to fall from this height wouldn't be dangerous that much, because it's I'm only one story up, I'm not three stories up. The last fall was a three-story fall, which is completely understandable as to why it broke me badly. Alright, there we go. Circumnavigation. We're in the money. And I've got 6 planks left over. Deposit them here. That's 9 planks total. And it's midnight. Oh, perfect. October the 3rd. I am going to actually save and load so that those new additions to the base become inside. I think all I have to do is a quick save load cycle for that to happen. And then have you guys vote on next goals. Once apparently getting the menu is tough. Hey, Zomboid. There we go. Sometimes it just be like that. So viewer suggestion for Lewis. We have got build a proper bedroom. Light up the base. Build a hut to fish. Build a bridge to the southwest. Hang on, I'll type up the rest in a second. Does this work? Is this all inside now? Yeah, I think it worked. It's dark as hell, because I don't have lights in this section of the factory or warehouse, but it worked. Go to the baseball bat factory. Roof the bridge to the southwest. Well, okay, that's kind of a duplicate. Add railings to walkways. There we go. 2.5 minutes. You guys vote. While Louis sleeps in. Wow, 11 hours of sleep? I don't think I've had 11 hours of sleep this year. Or even last year. That is a luxurious amount of sleep. Although I'm not, building walkways by day. So Louis has a good reason to be a lot more tired. What I'm going to do right now is to build doors. Where I have door frames. And then you guys will decide what's next. I just, I think door frames make sense. Especially if I'm trying to cover the, I did that wrong. Of course I did. Especially if I'm trying to cover the windows. That's what I was going to say. Let me try to build a door frame, which is not a wall frame. Oh, I already have a door frame here. Then just build a door. I'm gonna be out of wood. So I build one door frame. Build the other. Oh, can I just disassemble? Yeah, that works. Didn't need the sledgehammer. All right, there we go. And I've moved the sledgehammer into construction because it's kind of more of a construction tool than anything else. The weight is down to 83, so it's a lot more reasonable. Also, I'm not limping. Oh, okay. I still have a fracture, but with no visible limp. Okay there, game. Alright, what did you guys vote for? A proper bedroom. Okay, cool. It was a trick. I know, right? I think a proper bedroom would be over here. In this part of the base. Using the floor space that I already have over here. Because it's next to my clothing, right? And my washer and dryer. So it's already sort of bedroom-esque. Here's the question. Can I pick this oak bed up? Yes. All my oak bed are belong to us. So I'm going to go with a corner bed. And then I'm going to want to bring the books. No, maybe I don't bring the books. I'm going to want to bring the radio. Or I like the radio actually where it is, but I do want to bring the TV over in that corner. And then what else do I want in a bedroom? I could bring the arcade stuff to it too. But that's not really bedroom, if you ask me. I'm gonna want a nightstand. Absolutely. 49% fuel. Let's top it up. And lights. And dressers. Yeah, exactly. So what is this at? 79? So let's go shopping next door. I'm gonna want some furniture. I wouldn't mind an antique stove, but we didn't have one in this factory. I could shop for one of those too. I'm also probably gonna want to add more floor space. So for furniture that I don't want to bring over, I can just break down for material. Yeah, let's get a proper bedroom. Did I leave the base without food? I did. Well, I won't be out too long. So, if I am not mistaken, the entire first floor of this place is cleared. So I'm not really going to bother with too much first floor looting. Other than to grab a few hinges, because I'm low on hinges. Doorknobs. Because I might want to add eventually like walls to the bedroom so that it's walled up. But guard up, because I'm in unexplored territory here. Potentially fraught with zombies. Oh, canned goods. Also want curtains. I'm gonna want four curtains, I believe, I'm lacking for my base. There's three uncovered windows and then one window that just has a sheet over it, so that could be fixed. And we've got a nightstand already. Well, I might want a nightstand that I can put stuff on. So I take that back. Because I'm going to want a TV on it or something. Or maybe that could be a standalone table. So yeah, I'll take this nightstand. Throw that in my backpack. Don't ask how. I'll take this table and chair. And then I'll come back for more fun stuff. But getting the basics is nice. First IKEA, and then spruce it up. The no limping is very, very nice, I will say. Even if I do technically have a fracture. So we've got that. Got our table. Chair. Let me go get the TV. I wonder if the TV is close enough to the generator where it is here. Probably. TVs have pretty good range. Yep, power source nearby. Good. Okay, lights, a lamp. A lamp would be really nice. So, just nice things to have. I don't really have a specific shopping list. Just, we'll know it when we see it. You know, it's one of those. And time for some roughage. So it's 4 p.m. So this would probably be my last run before going to sleep. Like, in-game, not in real life. Getting a trash can in the bedroom. I'm trying to think of what's in my bedroom. And then, of course, there's, like, loads of loot here as well. Oh, I forgot to put the curtains down. The curtains that weigh 2 pounds. Lead curtains. What happened to my shin? I fell. I fell and broke it real good. Wow, look at all this food. I'm not here for food, but if I was, there's quite a lot of it. I'm trying to, like, mentally tell myself, guard up, guard up, guard up. A metalwork magazine for metal sheets. Neat. Your smile, your kiss. I don't have antibiotics. That's a really nice find. I did maybe want a mirror. And then we're getting the rest of the white curtains that I want. Am I a looter? I feel like I'm looting now. We've crossed over from surviving to just straight looting. Also, corned beef, you are being eaten because I'm hungry. And my broccoli is still frozen. Nothing wrong with a little looting here? Yeah, agreed. So I think the other issue is these bedrooms aren't going to have anything, like, besides possible magazines and the like, they're not going to have anything different from one another. I mean, I could go to the pzmap.net and, like, check that to be true. But my point is, I feel like, you know what? I'll grab beer. My point is, like, I'm mostly just picking from the same stock. So if I want something unique, I'm going to have to go somewhere else, like a different apartment complex, or even like the pawn shop might have a different selection. I'll try one more room. But yeah, I'll probably want to shop elsewhere, because it looks like the apartment complex of mass IKEA garbage is pretty much out of offerings now. So let's get the curtains up and hit the sack. Oh, I can even sprint on a fractured shin. Oh, you know, one other thing that I wouldn't mind is that corkboard over there. I have sort of the equivalent. Not in my bedroom, but sort of the equivalent. I have a bunch of whiteboards. Not a bunch. I have two whiteboards in the house to keep track of, like, chores and things. Groceries, etc. You know. The stuff you need to track. Let's get rid of these stupid curtains. Put the nice ones in. We're making it homey. As homey as a warehouse can be. That's not what I meant to hit, but okay. I definitely need a few more pieces of wood to make this not break my leg 2.0, but you know, in due time. One thing I didn't get is lights or anything like that. But except for one missing door, I am fully enclosed now. Definitely need a light. That I'm feeling. But I like it. It's very simple. It's very Spartan. All right, let's do another round of viewer suggestions. I am going to refund you all and spend one more day making the bedroom nice. But I'm taking suggestions from you guys in the Channel Point Redemption for the next day. One thing I haven't checked in a while is the diseases of my plants. So let's go do that. I also haven't read that next farming book too. I know that's overdue. We have mildew on second plot of cabbage. Got it. Yeah, in this specific series, light bulbs don't burn out unless I put them as headlights and drive into things. So adding lights is reasonable. I just find it so ridiculous. In Zomboid that, like, light bulbs burn out every week, that I don't think it's unreasonable to disable that. Alright, we have got mildew tended to. Crops are good. So, this series is close to vanilla, but not truly. Not truly vanilla apocalypse. There's a few tweaks. Night is a bit brighter, and light bulbs don't burn out. Those are the only tweaks. And the night being brighter is mostly for your viewing experience, so that you're not looking at a pitch black nothingness. Not a lot of it, at least. Oh, I forgot to put the beer away, too. So antibiotics are in. All the hinges. So all I need is a little bit of wood for the door. And the beer bottle. Oops, I put it on the floor. Oh well. Don't forget about the corkboard. I'll do it in the morning. Good point. Alright, suggest goals, because once I'm up, I'm going to have you guys vote on them. Tis the time. Where'd the corkboard go? I don't see it in my inventory anymore. Like, at all? I deleted it? Yeah. Did I never pick it up? I thought I grabbed it. Maybe I grabbed something else. Let me fix the beer that I meant to frame properly. There we go. Oh, yeah, I just left it. I picked it up, but I just... yeah. Go find a working vehicle. So, to suggest goals, it is Channel Point Redemption, but not that one. There's my cork board in the kitchen. That makes sense. Okay, so let's... I'll write these up now. What to do tomorrow. So we've got bridge to the southwest building, go to the baseball factory, cut down trees for planks for like other projects, secure the area, get coffee, and drive around town to a point of interest. Thank you for tuning in to Project Zomboid, King of Louisville, which originally streamed live on Twitch February 23rd. If you have any feedback or questions for me, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to catch a live stream of mine, Rhadamant.com has my stream schedule and countdown timers to upcoming streams. If you would like to join my gaming community, Rhadamant.com also has a link to Discord, as does the description of this video. Thank you so very much for watching. A special thank you to my Patreon patrons, Twitch subscribers, and viewers like you that support the channel and made it all the way to the credits. Thank you so very much. I hope to catch you next episode or an upcoming stream. Farewell, my fellow zombie survivors.